Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum dear students. Today in 10th class we are starting second unit, the reading of the lesson Chinese New Year. Earlier we completed the reading of our first lesson and I attempted some part of grammar also and some part of exercises I left for you. Though after inshallah some time we'll come back to our first unit, first lesson, and there I would like to discuss answers to different questions given there. Well, today we are starting our next lesson, Chinese New Year. Now, as a matter of fact, in different cultures, different calendars are being used. As you know, in a vast part of the world, Christian calendar, Gregorian calendar is in use, whereas in the Islamic world, Hijri calendar is also used. Similarly, in India, their calendar is called Bikrami calendar. And in some other parts, in Iran for example, their Hijri calendar is based on solar system, on it's basically a solar calendar. Solar, you know, means related to the sun. Now the Chinese calendar is basically a lunar calendar, as is our Islamic calendar. Lunar related to the moon. Luna in Latin is called, is used for the moon. So let's start the lesson. Chinese New Year, the first paragraph. Chinese New Year is a holiday that celebrates the beginning of a new year according to the Chinese lunar calendar. A holiday, when we use this word holiday, usually the thought comes to mind that it is a holiday is freedom from work, but a holiday is sometimes used for a festival, a celebration. So Chinese New Year is a festival or a celebration that celebrates. To celebrate is to celebrate is to jubilate, to make jubilation, to arrange some happy occasion. So it celebrates the beginning of a new year according to the Chinese lunar calendar. As I told you, lunar means related to the moon. So Chinese calendar is based on different phases of the moon. It is considered to be one of the most important holidays for Chinese families. To consider is to regard, to think of. So it is thought of, it is regarded as a very important occasion for Chinese families. The holiday is celebrated with big family gatherings, gift giving, the eating of symbolic food, and display of festive decorations, all focused on bringing good luck for the new year and celebrating the coming of spring. So, different things done on this occasion have been listed here. First of all, the writers tell us that family gatherings, family parties are arranged. Gift giving is also a very important part of this occasion. Gifts are exchanged. And some symbolic food. Symbolic is derived from the word symbol. A symbol is a sign. So some symbolic food, food as a sign of joy, as a sign of happiness, as a sign of blessing, is also cooked on this occasion. And then there are different festive decoration. Festive decoration means decorations used on festive occasions, on happy occasions, they are displayed, they are exhibited, they are shown, all focused on bringing good luck. And the focus of, the center of all these things is to bring good luck for the new year and to celebrate the advent of, arrival of the spring season. In China, the lunar calendar is still used to determine traditional holidays like Chinese New Year. So, traditional holidays, traditional occasions, traditional festivals are decided on the basis of the sighting of the moon according to the lunar calendar, Chinese lunar calendar. Since the lunar calendar is based on the phases of the moon, which has a shorter cycle than the sun, Chinese New Year is never on the same day each year, but typically falls somewhere between January 21st and February 20th. Now, as this lunar calendar is based on different phases, phases is different stages of the moon, different forms of the moon. You know that the moon on the first day is quite different from the moon on the seventh day, for example, or the moon on the 14th day. So, the first day moon is called the crescent. So, the full moon is on 14th day. So, these are different phases, different forms, different shapes of the moon. So, as Chinese calendar is based on these phases of the moon, and you know that the moon revolved around the earth in a shorter period than the earth revolved around the sun. So typically the moon completes its circulation around the sun, around the earth rather, in almost 355 to 356 days, whereas the earth completes its rotation around the sun in about 365 or 366 days. So there is a difference of 10 days between these two rotations. So Chinese New Year is never on the same day each year, because a difference of some days occurs. So the Chinese New Year doesn't start on the same day each year, but typically falls somewhere between January 21st and February 20th. So typically means as a rule, as a type. Typically is derived from type. So typically means as a rule, as a principle. It falls between January 21st and February 20th. Celebrations can actually last up to a month. And the celebration of the arrival of the new year start even before that arrival, and they continue for almost 1 month. Last means continue year. Last as a verb means continue. Here are some traditional traditions associated with Chinese New Year. So now some traditions, some customs, some conventions related to, associated means related to, linked with the Chinese New Year are enumerated. They are listed here. Cleaning houses and new clothes. The first thing is how the Chinese people wear new clothes and how they keep their houses clean for the welcoming of the new year. Prior to the first day of the new year, it is customary for families to thoroughly clean their houses. Prior to means before the arrival of the first day of the new year, it is customary, it is a convention, it is a tradition in Chinese families to thoroughly means completely, clean their houses. Doing this is said to clear out any bad luck from the previous year and to make the house ready to accept good luck for the coming year. Now, Chinese people in some respects are superstitious also. Being superstitious means to believe in illogical things, to believe in things which have no logical or rational basis. So, according to some people there in China, cleaning their houses on the occasion of the arrival of New Year clears out, sweeps out the bad luck of the previous year, and the house becomes ready to welcome the good luck of the New Year. All cleaning must be finished before New Year's Day, so there is no chance of accidentally throwing out the good fortune of the New Year. And another superstitious belief there is that the cleaning, the process of cleaning must be completed before the actual arrival of the New Year Day, because as soon as the New Year Day arrives, there is a chance for the good luck of the New Year to be swept out if the sweeping or cleaning is being done on that occasion. To throw out, to sweep out, to throw means to get rid of good fortune, good luck. Wearing black is not allowed due to its association with death. However, wearing red is encouraged as the color is associated with warding off bad spirits. In choosing color, especially colors of dresses, Chinese people are very careful. Black dress is usually associated with death, and it is actually a universal universal thing, universal tradition, that black color is associated with death. So it is not allowed to wear on the first day of the New Year, whereas wearing red cloth, wearing red dress is encouraged, because red color is a color of joy, as well as it is associated with warding off. To ward off is to get rid of, to push out bad spirits. They believe in bad spirits also, in ghosts and other such spirits, evil spirits. So it is believed that red color keeps them away from the people. Then the next tradition is decorating the house. Another popular custom is to hang up signs and posters on doors and windows with the Chinese word Fu written on them. So another popular custom, another convention there is to hang, to put on walls and doors, signs and posters with the Chinese word Fu. So and on those signs and posters, Chinese word Fu is written, which means luck and happiness. Buying flowers for the home is also commonplace. It is also very popular. It is commonplace. It is usual. It is ordinary thing to buy flowers for the home, since they symbolize the coming of spirit, coming of spring and new beginning. Because flowers are, you know, associated with the spring season, and it's the occasion of the arrival of the spring season, and they also indicate new beginning, new start. New Year's Eve dinner. On the eve of the Chinese New Year, it is customary to visit relatives. Eve is used for occasion. Eve is an abbreviated form of evening. New Year Eve means evening before the New Year. On the eve of Eid, for example, the evening before the Eid. So on the eve of the Chinese New Year, the evening before the Chinese New Year start, it is customary to visit relatives. So it is a convention there to visit relatives, to visit brothers, sisters, parents and other relatives, and partake in a large dinner where a number of specific foods are served. And partake means to take part, to eat. Partake is also used for eating. So it is a custom there to arrange parties in which different people of the family participate, and they also eat different dishes which are prepared on this special occasion. It is typical for a Chinese family to make 8 to 9 dishes for the New Year's Eve dinner, because in Chinese language, the word 8 means prosperity and the word 9 means long lasting. So it is also a convention there to prepare, to cook 8 to 9 dishes, because in the Chinese language, the word 8 also means prosperity. Prosperity is happiness, especially wealthiness. Prosperity is wealthiness, joy of being wealthy, prosperity. And the word 9 means long lasting. Long lasting means durable, something that lasts long, that is durable, that continues, that survives for a long time. Giving good luck gifts. It is a traditional practice for adults to give children little red envelopes filled with money in order to symbolize wealth and prosperity for the coming year. Another tradition there, another custom there, is for adults to offer to give their children or young ones little red envelopes which have some money in them, and it's also a symbolic way of welcoming the new year, the good fortune or good luck of the new year for the children. Money symbolizes wealth and prosperity for the coming year. It is also common for elders to present red packets to unmarried members of the family. Similarly, other than children, unmarried members of the family also have their gifts. They also get their gifts. Elders offer those gifts to them to offer red packets, and those gifts are usually in red packets. Envelopes are not to be opened until the recipient has left the home of the giver. And it is against the custom, it is against manners, it is considered unmannerly to open the envelopes before the recipient, one who has received. So the recipient, the receiver, has left the home of the giver. So it is not a good manner if those envelopes are opened before the persons who have already gifted those animals to them. Honoring the animal. Every year is associated with one of the 12 animals of the Chinese zodiac. Zodiac is a calendar system. Zodiac consists of different phases of different stars and planets. There are 12 stars and planets in all zodiacs. In Chinese zodiac, those stars and planets are associated with 12 animals. These animals are often represented in decoration. And these 12 animals, as they are associated with different months of the year, so they are represented on different decorative and festive things. Some people believe that those born during the year of a particular animal may have the character traits of that animal. And again, it's a superstitious belief that if a person is born in a certain year bearing the name and characters of that particular animal, it is there is a chance for that person to have the character traits, to have the qualities of that animal in his personality. So students, we are almost at the end of the lesson now. Just the last paragraph, a 3-line paragraph is there. Chinese New Year is a time when the family should come together in order to give thanks for the year that has passed and reinvigorate themselves for the coming year. So Chinese New Year is an occasion, is a time, is an occasion when the whole family gets together, when the whole family comes together, all the members of the family come back to their original home, and there they gather in order to give thanks for the New Year. And there they offer thanks to their gods for the New Year that has for the year that has passed. They are thankful for the blessings of the previous year, and they reinvigorate. Reinvigorate means to re-energize, to get back energy, to renew their energy for the coming year. So in that way, they come together and get new energy to survive and to spend the new year in a successful way. So students, here the reading of the lesson comes to an end. Inshallah, in our next lesson lecture, we'll come to the exercise of this lesson. Thank you very much.